Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Josh, and this is your stimulus check update for the next stimulus package for Monday, March 15th. I hope everyone is off to a good and safe start to their Monday so far, and that you all have a wonderful week ahead. In this video, I'll be discussing updates in regards to the current relief package and the third stimulus check. I'll also be discussing the possibility of a fourth stimulus check, the timelines of receiving the third payment, and then I'll be wrapping up this video by answering some of the comments and questions that I received in my previous video. But first, if you wouldn't mind real quickly liking this video, give me a big thumbs up. It really just helps with the YouTube algorithm in terms of pushing this video out to other viewers like you, and hopefully helping other people like you as well. Okay, so with most direct payments from the third round going out on Wednesday, many people are left to wonder, is this going to be the last round of checks? While chances are, we probably won't be receiving any additional money after this one, one lawmaker in rural Kana continues the fight for recurring stimulus checks. In a tweet, Kana said, "A one-time $1,400 check is simply not enough to pay the bills. We're 1 year into this pandemic, and many Americans are living paycheck to paycheck. This past $2,000 monthly stimulus checks." So in Kana's eyes, the $1,400 checks just passed weren't nearly enough, and further relief should be passed. That's one side of the political spectrum. On the other side, we have Republican lawmakers such as Rand Paul, who believe all this extra spending by the government, or taxpayers I should say, needs to come to a halt. Just recently, the Congressional Budget Office warned that within the next 30 years, taxpayers could be forced to pay up to $61 trillion in interest payments. So at some point, we will have to dig into the current deficit. The only question is, when? Senator Paul said, "I, for one, have advocated that there is another answer to our current problems. Instead of printing more money and making believe that this money will retain its value as it is sprinkled across the land, we could remove the government shackles that have caused a depression in the restaurant, retail, and entertainment sectors of our economy. Instead of passing out free money, we could simply end the lockdowns. The daily incidence of the virus is in freefall. In addition, there is no evidence that the government lockdowns have worked. I don't know if I'll make it to 2050, but my kids will, and I hope that soon enough voters will decide that there is no such thing as a free lunch, and debt today becomes massive interest payments tomorrow." So obviously, there's quite the contrast in the way lawmakers such as Ro Khanna think, and how other lawmakers such as Rand Paul think. With that said, if we do see another relief package, more than likely, it won't come until around July, around the time they try passing their bill based around infrastructure. Also, with the unemployment benefits from the most recent reconciliation bill expiring on September 6th, it's possible they end up passing one more, perhaps smaller bill before then, extending those benefits through the end of the year. Along with that, we could see one more round of checks, although nothing is for certain. With everything else, we'll just have to wait and see. Until then, of course, many people are still waiting for their third direct payments of $1,400. As mentioned earlier, most of these are going to be sent out via direct deposit on Wednesday, but if you haven't checked your payment status yet, I would highly recommend doing so by checking through the payment portal. If you're still receiving the payment status of not available, then that doesn't necessarily mean that you're ineligible to receive the payment. All that means is, for whatever reason, the IRS doesn't have enough information to know whether you're eligible or not. That, or perhaps, they just haven't yet assigned a payment date. If you received your first and second direct payment, and your income hasn't changed since then you should also be eligible for this one. So, no worries there. In the meantime, just continue checking every single day, and eventually, you will get an update. Okay, so at this point in time, I'm going to move right along to answering some of the comments and questions that I received in my previous video. And if you do have any other comments or questions for me, please feel free to leave them in the comment section below. I do try to answer as many of the comments and questions as I possibly can, but for those comments and questions I'm not able to respond to, I do try to pick some of the more popular ones to answer in the next video in video form. Okay, so without further ado, let me go ahead and jump into the first comment of this video, which is from LaShonda. LaShonda says, "I do not work. I'm on SSI and I have 3 kids. Do I get the $1,400 for my kids?" Okay, thank you so much for your question, and yes, not only will you be receiving $1,400 for yourself, but you'll also be receiving $1,400 for each of your kids as well. So in total, for this next direct payment, you'll be receiving $5,600. Also, starting in July, you'll be receiving the near monthly advanced child tax credit payments, which will be up to $3,600 yearly per child. So, depending on their ages, you could receive up to $10,800 in total for your three children if they're all under the age of six. This, of course, will be on top of the $5,600 you'll be receiving from these stimulus checks. Okay, moving along to the next comment video, which is from Stephanie. Stephanie says, I checked my status and it showed that it would be deposited on the 17th. However, they did indeed use my old bank account in which the bank is no longer in existence. Since the bank is gone, how will the deposit balance and send back to the IRS so I can receive a paper check? How long would it take to receive a paper check? Okay, thank you so much for your question. And once the IRS attempts to send you the next direct payment, they'll be able to see that it's an invalid account. Once they're unable to send the payment via direct deposit, then at that point, they'll send you a check in the mail instead. For some people in the last round of direct payments, it took around 3 to 4 weeks for paper checks to be processed and sent in the mail. So this time around, I would expect for them to take about the same amount of time. With that said, given that time frame, I would expect, at latest, you should receive your check in the mail by the middle of April. Once they change your method to a paper check, the payment portal should also update. So in the meantime, I would definitely keep checking that to watch for any updates. All right, moving along to the next comment video, which is from Tiwania. Tiwania says, Hi Josh, how would I find out about my check? I have direct deposit and the website keeps saying wrong information or it's saying close. I'm crying. What do I do? Help. Okay, thank you so much for your question. And first off, I'm incredibly sorry for everything that you're currently going through. I know that it's definitely not easy. Secondly, if it's still saying that your information is incorrect, that should definitely not impact you in receiving the next direct payment. However, there are some things that you can definitely check for your payment status. The first thing that I would recommend for you to do is to make sure that all of your information is filled in correctly. It could be that since the IRS is basing your physical street address off your 2019 tax returns, if you moved recently, you may be typing your new address in the payment portal. In this case, you'd want to use your old street address since the IRS is basing your payment off of your last year's returns. Another trick you could try is to type your street address in with all capital letters or even try abbreviating it. So, for example, instead of typing in drive, type in DR. If you try doing that and you're still not having any luck, at that point, I would recommend trying to call the IRS to check for any updates. The best number you can reach them at would be 1-800-919-9835. And the only recommendation I would have is to call just a little bit earlier in the day just to avoid those longer hold times. Again, just because you're unable to check the payment portal doesn't mean that you won't receive a check. I know it's a bit frustrating not being able to see your direct deposit date, but for most people, it's going to be on Wednesday. So in the meantime, just continue checking your bank account. Hopefully, even if you're unable to see your payment status, you'll still receive it very soon. Okay, moving along to the next comment video, which is from Samuel. Samuel says, if my 2020 taxes are still processing, are they going to go off my 2020 or 2019 taxes? Okay, thank you so much for your question. And if the IRS hasn't yet processed your 2020 tax returns, then in that case, they'll base your payment off your returns for 2019. However, if you're supposed to receive a larger payment based off of your returns for this year, then once they finish processing your returns, they'll send you an adjusted payment. On the other hand, if you're supposed to receive a smaller payment based off of your 2020 returns, then in that case, they won't garnish any of your payment in order to make it smaller. For example, if you earn more money in 2020 in order to qualify, then they won't garnish your $1,400 payment based off of your returns for 2019 if they've already sent your payment. I do hope that makes sense. All right, so on that note, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up this video. If you did enjoy the content in this video and you'd like to see more videos like it, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. It is completely free to do so, and it's a great support to me. Also, if you'd like to receive 2 free socks from Webull, with both of them valued all the way up to $1,800 each, or 1 free sock from Robinhood just for signing up and linking your bank account, please feel free to claim those free socks by clicking the link in the description box below. And finally, if you join Rakuten with my referral link in the description box below and spend at least $30, Rakuten will give you $30 cash back. This means that you can buy an item through Rakuten with one of their referral links, such as Nike, for $30, and Rakuten will give you $30 just for making that purchase. This is just an incredible deal that I would love for everyone to take advantage of. Okay, so until next time, I'll see you guys and I hope you have a great day today.